Hi everyone, welcome to my first video on YouTube. I'm Ollie of Ollie's Exotics and today I'm going to be doing a video on cleaning my stick insect enclosure out. I just wanna feel your love. Okay, so at the beginning of the video I realised I said I was going to be cleaning the enclosure out for the phasmids, but I've actually decided to turn it into a bioactive enclosure now. So I'll go through the steps of you once I have emptied it out, and I'll show you what you need to do. But this is what it looks like at the moment, just with the bramble. I've got some Sungaia stick insects in here and some thorny stick insects, Aratheon asperimus. But yeah, at the moment I've just got some sphagnum moss in here, some leaf litter, I got some dairy cow isopods back there, but just behind that cork bark, you can't see them obviously, but I'm going to be taking them out and creating a bioactive drainage layer, and hopefully not all of my springtails will be lost in the process, but we'll see how it goes. Right, so I've just emptied my enclosure out. It was full of some wood lice, dairy cow, isopods, which are Porcellia laevis, and it was full of my stick insects. I've just emptied them out, which was a bit stressful, but now it's an empty enclosure. I'm going to put the drainage layer on now for my bioactive setup. Okay guys, so I've created a drainage layer. I've cut a bit of mesh out and put it on top to stop when I put the topsoil and cocoa fibre on, it won't go through and mess it all up. But before I do that, I'm going to put some charcoal on to create a neutralisation layer, so I'll just do that. So I have added the charcoal on top of the mesh. This is the neutralisation layer, as I said before. You don't want to add too much charcoal, this much is about fine. I'm going to add the springtails in. I'll just squeeze it. I have just put the cocoa fibre and topsoil on top of the springtails and the charcoal now, and I've added a load of leaf litter, a load of moss, and I've put the water pot in for the stem of bramble that I'm about to collect in a second. So that's what it looks like at the moment. It's relatively higher than it was before, and that's what the layer looks like. All the springtails and all the springtails and the wood lice, the dairy cow wood lice, are all roaming around. There is a big log behind there that I just put in. You can't see it now because it's camouflaged in, but they're all underneath that. I only bought 5 the other day, and there's about 30 in there now, so that just shows dairy cow isopods are really good. They're prolific breeders. But yeah. Okay, so I'm just going to add the bramble stem now that I just picked out. This is it. Sorry for the bad camera angle for a minute. That's what it looks like. Doesn't look the best at the moment, but that's what it is. I'm gonna add the stick insects. Okay, so I'm just adding the stick insects here. They want to cooperate, that would be great. Okay. Now the nymphs is gonna be another story. Okay, so the nymphs have been added now. I was gonna film it, but I decided it would be too much of a hassle to film all of that. But yeah, this is the finished look. It does look a bit squished at the moment because the plant's drooped, but you can see that's a male, either a male Aratown asparamus or a Sungai inspectata, but they do look similar. So there's him. And then we have some nymphs. Yeah. That one's got a kind of a greeny on it, green colour to it, so hoping to get some different morphs out of them. But yeah, I've got all my moths down there. And yeah, that's what it looks like. So everyone, thanks for watching my first video. And please make sure to like the video if you liked it, and if you disliked it, just put the thumbs down. Please turn the bell notification on so you know when I upload my new videos, and please subscribe. See you later.